What's up, guys? This is Hatai at 7R60 Gaming, bringing you another video for you guys. Today I have something, again, off the left field, kind of, because it's something that I wanted to work on for quite some time. After doing the review that I did, kind of like a minor review I did on Squadrons, if you remember correctly, I expressed that there were two things that I really would have loved to try out when playing the game for the first time, and one was VR. Obviously, that's something that I cannot dive into right now. And the other was having a HOTAS control or a similar flight stick that I could use so I can enjoy much more of the game. Now, this brings to a very interesting thing in my mind, and it's that even though I'm not someone who is limited or stuck to needing to have a specific controller in order to enjoy the game, there are instances where, depending on the right controller, you know, you can have a much more great time or fun with any given game. Case in point, for example, the reason why I did the Back to the Basics videos to begin with, you know, to highlight certain genres and certain games where having a different controller from a gamepad will kind of make, you know, benefit. You will be able to benefit from having a different control scheme, closer to probably maybe how it was intended in the arcades, or maybe it's due to the genre. There's very, you know, a lot of different reasons why this is the case. Now, it's not something that happened like overnight, because if you remember back in the day, remember that big Steel Battalion controller that Capcom came out that time with that game? You know, that's just one example of going crazy with the controller to immerse you into the game that you're playing. Now, it happens with fighting games, it happens with, you know, shoot 'em ups, and I showcase that here with the videos. You know, when I do shoot 'em up genres, I always like a specific arcade stick, because it brings me closer to the experience that I had either in the arcades, or it's simply just better controlling that way. So for today, flight sticks, of course, is something that I'm throwing into the mix, because even though it's not a defined genre when you go around looking for emulation and stuff like that, I wanted to highlight that there are certain games in there, in the arcade classics, that would benefit greatly from having a flight stick. Now, of course, this led me to want to make a small collection of like the best games to play with flight sticks, and it's what you're going to be seeing in a few minutes. Now, believe me, I'm not telling you guys to go out running and buy a flight stick. This just so happened to coincide basically with the arrival of my flight stick, the Thrustmaster HOTAS 1 for the Xbox One, I think it was. And I got it for completely different reasons. The reason primarily is because I want to enjoy games like Star Citizen and Squadrons and Ace Combat even. And I like these games. I really enjoy them. So while testing those, I realized that it would be awesome to actually play the arcade games as well, because, you know, you gotta try and make the best of what you spend your money in. So if any of you guys out there have a flight stick lying around that you're not using, or maybe you're thinking about getting one but you're afraid that it's only gonna serve you for one game, then I guess this video is for you, because that's exactly the point. You can download this collection. You need to configure, of course, many of the games, especially on the console side. I did not create the packs that were made. This is part of the core. It's just a sub collection that allows you to have all in one place basically all the flight games that would benefit a lot from a flight stick. So I know that intro was extremely long and I kept babbling, but let's go into that and I can show you what I'm talking about here. Of course, you already have the crap cam here set up. You have this. Now, of course, This stick right here, this is not the my preferred way of using this flight stick, because this separates right here in the middle. I'm gonna show you a picture of how I prefer to play it. And yeah, as you can see, I like to have them more apart, because that way I can have, you know, I can rest my arms on the chair and have it in a way where it's not gonna get in the way. Here, I feel it, for me at least, is a bit constrained. But for the sake of the crap cam camera, I just put them together, locked them up so you can see. So let's go into core here. And we're gonna go into the direction part. Now I'm gonna leave a download link in my video in the description area, so if you're interested in getting it, just download it from the link. It's a small collection, and it contains basically files. I'm gonna have to, of course, edit out the music from this, because it's the Top Gun song, so I know I'm gonna get copyrighted over that, but you'll be able to enjoy it if you add it to your build. So yeah, it's a total of 60 games. Now, more can be added, of course. I just picked what I thought were like the ideal games to play using the flight stick. Now, I'm going to show you a few. Like, let's say, for example, the first one that's going to come to mind, Afterburner. So let's go into this one. Now, out of the games that I included here that are MAME, you know, once you set up the controllers, you don't have to go back and do it again. For each console, however, you're going to have to basically go into the emulator itself and configure and add, you know, the flight stick configuration to your liking. So there's nothing here set in stone that's going to work across everything. But it can be done, and you can have tons of fun. I have the credit button, I think, set here, and the Y button behind the thruster lever, if you, if that's the correct term for that. And then we start it up. Classic Afterburner with classic controls, basically from the arcade. And you can see trigger and missiles with this button right here, and I crash and burn, baby. Don't worry, I gotcha. Of course, the stick will not make you a better gamer, but it will make it much more fun. Of course, a lot of the best games that you can play with a flight stick are mostly on PC and stuff. But that doesn't mean you can't have fun with the arcade games as well. Now, let's say something like, I included some that are not exactly spaceflight, but are also extremely fun to play with, you know, this type of controller set where you can basically configure the buttons however you want. Yeah, I could have added more, but I didn't want to get off the theme of the whole flight thing. But you can add on your own, easy enough with a subfile. Now take for example, Prop Cycle is another game that you can enjoy a ton. You can configure the buttons for the propeller and stuff like that. Either buttons included on the thruster or use the thruster itself to move back and forth. One that's pretty interesting, of course, Space Harrier is another one just like Afterburner that basically benefits from being able to move around a bit better. And of course, I have a whole bunch that I still haven't configured to use the buttons because I'm using primarily the stick for the bigger games, but, and Ace Combat is amazing. You can use it for all of these titles here, including Trilogy. And of course, I wasn't gonna allow to do this video and not include this one because it's one of the best cases for using a flight stick because it actually has a thruster element and it has a flight stick. So it's like it's made for it almost. All right, so here we go with Star Wars. Now this one I already configured, just like Mach Storm. But let's try this one out first so you can see. And there we go. We'll start choosing whichever stage you want. Got trigger, of course, here. Got the thruster to move when you're queued to do so, like right here in the beginning. It's just awesome. I mean, you don't exactly need it to enjoy this game, but it's so cool, and of course, this one in particular also vibrates, so it gives you a little bit more of the whole thing of the game. It's very, very nice. Speed up or slow down using the thruster. Very limited time to get them all. So the better you have control. Just so freaking fine, man. Thank you.
dock port and fire the torpedoes.
Use the force. Remember.
And force. There she goes.
Great shot, kid.
Hell yeah. So there you have it, guys. Let's get out of this one. Alright, so that was Star Wars. Let's get to another one. Now this one is kind of interesting because this one has the thruster inverted. I'm going to show you guys what I mean. Usually the thrusters you're kind of used to, like forward is to accelerate and pulling back is to decelerate. This time around is the opposite. You have speed up is down. And so yeah, if I make an ass of myself, please don't laugh. Laugh all you want. Let's add some credits and go for it. Off. Got triggers here. Gonna keep my speed. Now the missiles. I can stop if I want, or I can speed up. Can actually descend if I want. So that was a little practice run. Now I actually start playing. Now if you remember, this is the one arcade machine where you get to like move around and stuff, making it much, much better. I'm not gonna be able to recreate that just using a flight stick, but it gets me closer. Myself knocked the hell out. And I crashed through a building. Oh my god. Very bad pilot. Jeez. Let's do it again. Nope. Can't have it. Evade. The shots, please evade the shots. Yeah, that's gonna be the end of that one, but I need to come back to it again. It's a little confusing with the whole thing with the slowdown and slow up, but it's still a fun freaking game. And since I cannot fit or have or own this machine, this is the next best thing to it. So from here, let's do the last one here today. I am a little biased, so of course, I already did the Star Wars one. So why not do the last one being Mach Storm. Yeah. Let's go for this one. Alright, so here we go with Mach Storm now. Just like Star Wars, it's the same. It's basically done on the same system board. And it's the same style. I mean, you don't actually control all the flying, but yeah, it feels like you're actually doing it. It's on rails mostly, but it's still hell of a lot of fun. So let's add some credits and start it off. Again, very simplistic in terms of gameplay, but man, it feels freaking amazing to use this instead of a gamepad.
Storm one,
especially when you see the video cues on screen as well. Let's try
okay.
Paris.
Stand by. Storm one, you're cleared for takeoff. Push the throttle level forward and take off. AWACS Heavy Cloud, this is aircraft carrier Nicholas A. Anderson.
Let's do this.
The storm squadron under your command. They'll assist in intercepting the enemy forces.
This is AWACS Heavy Cloud. Roger that. Hostile aircraft have occupied the Paris skies. Eliminate them.
Enemy down.
Yeah.
Good job, Storm One. Let it go, Storm One.
Oh, that won't hit me.
Watch out for the missile. Storm one. Yeah. Pull
them out. Combo. Oops, boss.
Warning.
Boss fight.
Hey, shot, Storm One. We've got the curve over there.
Now this one is timed. Come on.
He's stunned. Fire away.
Come on.
Seconds to drop point.
Come on.
3, 2, 1.
Damn.
Sustained major damage.
Missed it.
Mission failed.
There you go. But it plays super freaking awesome. Just a matter of practicing, getting the timing down, but you know what I mean. Alright guys, so I think that's going to be the end of this one for now. Again, I'm going to leave the link so you can download it and add it to your core build. If you have a stick or if you don't and you plan on getting one, this would be a nice addition to it. And of course, this is the first of many videos that I'm going to be doing with gameplay featuring the flight stick. So yeah, that sounds like a wrap for now, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Please like and subscribe, and check the description down below so you can grab it. See you guys.